Hello and welcome. I'm Prachi Gupta and you are watching today's edition of our COVID-19 Bulletin, where we bring you daily updates on the scientific efforts being undertaken in the country to fight the dreaded coronavirus pandemic. Given the current coronavirus crisis, the search is on to find materials which can kill or inactivate the deadly virus. Scientists from the Institute of Nanoscience and Technology, or INST, an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technology, has made a nanomaterial for microbial disinfection. Earlier, antimicrobial nanomaterials were made of metals such as silver, which make them costly. The newly made antimicrobial nanomaterial is made of carbon nitride, which makes it cheaper. The carbon nitride nanoparticles have the ability to produce reactive oxygen species, which damages the lipids and protein components of the microbes, resulting in their inactivation. This mechanism is not specific to a particular microbe and can be used against all the microbes, including COVID-19. One major advantage of these nanoparticles is that they require visible light for disinfection and not UV rays, which require specific equipment. Scientists are exploring ways to add these nanoparticles to the clothing fabric so that clothes have the ability to deactivate and kill the microbes. If developed, such cloths can be especially useful for healthcare and other frontline workers who have higher chances of getting infected. Let's hear more about this coating from Dr. Asif Khan Shahnawaz and Dr. Kamala Kalan Kailasam, who are scientists at the Institute of Nanoscience and Technology and have made this nano coating.
Currently, silver and the metal oxide nanomaterials are used widely. The problem is either they are toxic or they are only active in visible region, UV light, or having lower activity. So that's an urge to develop an cost-effective and organic material which is polymeric in nature. It can be made using cheaper precursors like urea or melamine, which is very low cost. It is an organic semiconductor. This carbonate is an organic semiconductor with a narrow band gap and absorb light in the visible region, which we utilize it in our group on different energy applications. It is a highly stable polymer and compared to the other organic polymers, and it's stable in all pH conditions. It can be prepared as monoliths, it means on different solid shapes you want, and as nanoparticles or nanoporous materials, as a quantum dot, so that you have a high surface area.
We can understand that these nanomaterials damage the structural integrity as evidenced from the damage to the bacterial cell membrane. So coming to the present scenario, we know the inhabitants of the microbe world are primarily made of lipid, protein, and nucleic acids. And the term Kamal mentioned, ROS, reactive oxygen species, can interact most instantly with any lipid or protein molecules it comes across. So as a result, it ends up damaging these structures that the protein might end up losing its functionality and eventually the inactivation of the organism. So we envision that the mechanism might also hold true in case of viruses.
In these times of pandemic, healthcare workers are working 24/7 to treat and save the lives of coronavirus patients. In this selfless endeavor, they are putting their own lives at risk. To cut down on this danger, scientists from the Durgapur-based CSIR lab, Central Mechanical Engineering Research Institute, have come up with a robotic device. This robot can be used by medical workers to provide medicines and food to patients, collect their samples, and communicate without coming into physical contact with the patients. These devices can be controlled and monitored from the nursing stations on respective floors. This robot costs less than 5 lakh rupees and weighs less than 80 kilograms. Given its specific use in hospitals, it has been named as Hospital Care Assistive Robotic Device, or HCARD. We hope more such robots get manufactured and utilized by medical workers for taking care of infected patients. Coronavirus infection affects the respiratory system of a patient, causing difficulty in breathing. Although only 5% of the patients who get severely ill require ventilators, yet given the large population, the rise in the number of infected patients can cause a shortage of ventilators. To cut down on this shortage, some young Indian engineers have made a low-cost ventilator using locally available materials. The team comprises engineering students from Indian Institute of Technology or IIT Bombay, Srinagar-based National Institute of Technology and Islamic University of Science and Technology located in Jammu. The low-cost ventilator, which has been named Rudar, can provide adequate breathing support necessary to save life of a critically ill COVID-19 patient. The prototype cost only 10,000 rupees and the cost will further come down if produced on scale. That is all for today. We will be back with another edition of COVID-19 Bulletin soon. Till then, stay safe. Namaskar.